Hi, I'm Matt Rather, and we are overthinking Eurovision. This year, Switzerland is sending Rika, who is a favorite of all the Swiss crossword puzzle writers out there. She's actually from Canada originally, which might seem odd until you remember what other Canadian represented Switzerland in Eurovision. That's a 20-year-old Celine Dion, winning for Switzerland in 1988. So, Rika has got some big shoes to fill. Actually, more like 3,000 pairs of them. The song is called The Last of Our Kind, and at first this sounds like a pretty standard love song.
Soldier, take off your armor, show me your heart, this is hard.
So we have this image of a hero returning from the battlefield. That's a little odd because while Switzerland has a pretty large military, they rather famously choose not to use it. I'm hoping that she's actually talking about the Swiss guard that protects the Pope. She's like, soldier, take off your multicolored doublet because it's kind of killing the mood. Then we get to the chorus and things get interesting. See, if she hadn't already specified the guy was a soldier, I would have assumed this was a song about two pandas, with the female desperately trying to get the male to put down the goddamn bamboo for just one freaking second! So what is this song about? Well, birth rates in Western Europe have been low for a long time. Maybe this is imagining a dark future in which Switzerland is down to its last handful of citizens. They have heard the cuckoo at midnight, so to speak. But Switzerland's population is actually increasing thanks to immigration. They might get less blonde, but the Swiss aren't going away. And then I heard this lyric.
Here we are at the end of the movie.
And it all makes sense. Rika is trying to get into the lucrative business of end credits songwriting. A lot of classic songs were made famous in the end credits of movies. Everything I Do, I Don't Want to Miss a Thing, and oh yeah, Rika basically wants this woman's whole career. Rika clearly decided to write an end credit song for an existing movie as a way to show off her skills. This might even be a trend. In the recent Judd Apatow-produced comedy Love on Netflix, the main character gets his friends together to do exactly that.
It was the perfect song. It was the perfect song.
The question is, exactly what movie is this song describing? Last of Our Kind. The New World. Clearly, this is about The Last of the Mohicans starring Daniel Day-Lewis. Except wait, the Mohicans don't refer to where they live as the New World, do they? And I think by the end, there's actually only one Mohican left. It seems like this song is describing a situation where there are at least two so that one can serenade the other. That eliminates The Chronicles of Riddick, Dragonheart, The Last Witch Hunter, The Last Airbender, The Last Days of Disco, and the Peter Bogdanovich classic, The Last Picture Show. It could be about any of the Transformers movies. Those robots are the last of their kind after the destruction of Cybertron, although somehow there's more of them in every sequel.
Standing tall at the end of the story.
In the Divergent series, there are only a handful of Divergents running around Chicago, so that might work.
And it's stronger, stronger than water.
It could be about Game of Thrones from the point of view of the dragons.
We're the last of our kind. It's a whole new world, and we're facing the fire.
Highlander is a strong possibility. Ancient immortals battling each other for supremacy through the centuries. And look at this, there's a reboot in progress. Maybe Rika's got her eye on that.
We're the last of our kind. It's a whole new world.
The crew at Overthinking It actually debated this one for days. And in the end, there was one movie, and only one, we all agreed fits this song almost eerily well. We'll see you next time. Roll 'em!
Show me your heart. This is home.
We're home.
And it's
Thanks for watching Overthinking Eurovision. Here are some other videos you can watch. And here is a big button so you can subscribe to this channel and not miss anything. But if you really like what we do, we would love to have your support. Check out the Overthinking Eurovision Patreon page and become a patron there. It's patreon.com/Eurovision. And thanks for helping us to subject Eurovision to a level of scrutiny it probably doesn't deserve.